response to anything on this show.
What? Wait, is that a rocket kite?
You nasty.
What's up, Nasty Cats? It's your man behind the cam, aka Director, here with
Miss N.
We're here for another Yugi Toss episode 37 and 38 reaction. In the last episode, we got to see some wild stuff. Oh, we see that Malik finally got to take over Joey and got forced Yugi into a 1v1. He's like, box fight me, bro.
Honestly.
It was interesting. It was, at the end, the power of what?
Friendship.
Huh?
Friendship.
Say it again, shawty.
Friendship.
Man, fuck that noise. Save the day. No, actually, no. I'm not going with the power of friendship. Kaiba, Seto Kaiba, with his masterful gambit card throwing skills, saved the day.
Like, oh my god, those gambits. I was like, who is this? Who is this?
He think he an X-Man.
Oh my goodness.
He think he was Professor X.
Like, how?
Hey, Seto Kaiba got a little bit gangster.
Has him in the holsters?
The power's in the mullet.
Huh. Mm-hmm,
power's in the mullet.
I believe it.
At the end, we see Serenity magically one day at the hospital with her bandages off. Yo, is apparently...
They wrapped off right before she jumped in the water, right? Or did she see him before that? And all of a sudden, she's an Olympic swimmer? They just left that out of the whole story?
Apparently so. Moving forward, we're going to see if they're going to figure out who's the nefarious person behind all this mess and if they're going to be able to catch them. And, of course, not Duelist Kingdom, what's it called? A Battle City 2.0 tournament continues. Huh? So if you made this fun, you haven't already, drop a sub on the channel, drop a like on the video. We drop reactions 3 times a week on the channel, so make sure you turn on post notifications. Don't forget
to check the top pinned comment and the description below for all the socials, including the Reddit, the Discord, and the Patreon.
We have uncut, unreleased anime reactions. You can tell us episode 37 and 38 reaction coming up next. Hey, just a quick thank you to all the subs on the channel. You members of the Nasty Cast are the driving force that makes all this possible. Catch Director Nasty on Reddit, Patreon, and all other socials in the description below with links. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks again.
On Zork and Pals.
Hey, look who finally got his screen time.
Again.
Zork, you destroyed the world over a dozen times now. I'm not sure how you even managed it, but it's starting to get rather dull.
But you used to love it when I destroyed the world.
Yes, it used to excite me, but now it feels as though that's all we have. It's like we don't really have anything in common anymore.
That's not true. We both love genocide and crushing those who stand against us.
Zork, there's someone else. I've started seeing another villain, and believe it or not, he doesn't want to destroy the world.
Well, good, because I already did that.
I'm breaking up with you, Zork.
This is the saddest day of my life. Aww. I must find a way to express my misery.
Let me guess, you're going to destroy the world.
Yeah, no, I'm going to destroy the studio audience. Feel my
wrath. Wait, is that us?
God, we are so cancelled.
Nobody wants to see this. Nobody wants to see this.
I guess that's why it was never made. Even the theme song sucks.
Yes. He killed a puppy.
I believe it.
The Parkour Show? Oh, God. Whose idea was this?
His, obviously.
Oh, great. Now the fangirls have started invading my dreams, too.
What? It's me, you fool. Do I look like a f***ing fangirl?
You really don't want me to answer that. So, did you finish defeating Yugimoto yet?
Yeah, about...
So why does he look so different?
He's on my to-do list.
Oh, because he's in the shadow. He's in the shadow form. The ring form.
Like
the evil form.
Never mind that. We have bigger problems than Wanker's Cramp. And I never thought I'd say that. It seems that 4Kids is trying to appease the fan base by uploading the original Japanese episodes of Yu-Gi-Oh! To their YouTube account.
What? Why would they do such a thing? They are pure evil. I mean, they make us look like a couple of pansies. They must be up to something. Something truly sinister.
Could it be The Prophecy?
The Christopher Walken movie?
No, not that. The other Prophecy. The one that talks about four kids and how they'll bring about the end of the world.
Oh, God.
But we must act quickly. I shall have to defeat Yugi myself. In the meantime, why don't you go buy yourself some more spray-on tan?
Hey! F you! This tan is 100% genuine.
Yeah, genuinely awful. You look like that woman from the Transformers movies.
You mean Shia LaBeouf?
That's the one.
Oh, I...
Oh, y'all went after Shia? Damn!
I don't get torn to pieces by zombies or something. Because let me tell you, that would be so annoying.
Brains.
Brains. Oh, this
my
kid.
My late-night cemetery strolls are ruined.
Brains. Yeah, all we had to
I
do
was wondering
buy
why
a
he was holding
his
masks,
disc
in
the
middle of the cemetery.
He was lost and afraid.
It was the perfect plan.
If only Bandit Keith could see us now, he'd probably feel really stupid for kicking us out of his gang.
What do you mean you guys don't like Armageddon? Actually, boss, we don't like Michael Bay movies in general. Oh, that does it! Mess with Michael Bay and you mess with America. I want you guys out of my country by tomorrow morning.
Brains.
Mess with Michael
this
Bay
is Japan.
America.
To America. And how the bloody hell are we supposed to leave? I don't know.
I must
At least he said it. I don't know.
She was like, oh my god. And I was like, oh my god. And she was like, oh my god.
You, strange person, tell me where I can find a Battle City duelist or I shall ravage you with my face.
Oh my god. What are you wearing?
You sound nervous. Is it the accent? You want to know how I got it? My father was a drinker. One night he went a little crazier than usual, so my mummy got the teapot to defend herself. He didn't like that, so he pours boiling hot tea all over her. Then he comes at me with a teapot and he asks, why so British?
Oh my god, they're at the cemetery. Like, I'm so sure.
I thought that sounded familiar.
I was like, I heard it from the
Yo,
beginning.
I've heard that somewhere.
Is he really?
Well, at least you're not running.
Why so British? I can't stand that.
Since you have almost all your locator cards and I only have one, I suggest we play a winner-take-all card game. The victor goes to the Battle City Finals.
Don't worry, zombie boy. This guy's a pushover. He's not even a main character.
Yeah, he probably doesn't even have any decent monster cards.
I summon Pyramid Head in attack mode.
What? Pyramid Head? What is it? Dead by Daylight?
Much worse than the Shadow Realm, I've taken it to Silent Hill.
Come on, zombie boy. Show this guy who really rules the survival horror genre. Brains.
Oh my god, really?
What is this?
It's like Pyramid Head and Doctor about to make an ugly baby.
Bloody
yeah. Thank you.
Okay, you think their lips would come off on each other?
Yes, gross.
Zombie boy, you can talk.
Of course I can talk. I studied at Cambridge.
I thought you studied at zombie school.
Yeah, the Cambridge School for Zombies. Look it up. Well, then how come all you've ever said to us is brains?
Oh, gee, let me think. Maybe it's because it's in the fucking script.
It's highly degrading and I'm not gonna take it anymore.
Oh, there was a time when zombies were respected. Those were the days when George Romero didn't suck and the undead never broke into more than a stumble. And then along came 28 days later and suddenly we're being replaced by the infected. It's a joke. Well, I'm taking a stand. Not for me, but for my zombie brethren. We shall
you tell him, zombie boy!
...into the night, for we are...
Did you just shoot him in the head?
It's the only way to kill an overacting zombie. I suppose that makes me
true.
Winner.
Damn.
Yeah, but we'll get
damn, you saw he was holding it sideways for the kill shot, too.
Hey, man.
Oh, yeah, he's dead. I forgot.
Excellent. Now I have enough locator cards to enter the finals. You know, I've rather enjoyed having my own episode. It almost makes up for being thoroughly neglected for the past 2.5 years. Pyramid Head, stop humping Nemesis.
I was wondering what was going on.
Oh, you ain't know?
I didn't know. How am I supposed to know?
I knew he was humping him. Zork and Pals finale over Battlestar Galactica finale? Ah.
This can't be real. There's no way. This piece of has got to be a fake.
Right? Get that shit out of my face.
Korra has moved against us.
Just as the prophecy predicted.
Should we take him out?
No. Now nothing can stop us. Soon YouTube.com shall fall, and then this world will come to an end. It is inevitable. All hail Four Kids.
Oh my god. So that's episode 37. I guess that's the episode. They the comments had disappeared in time where Four Kids and WB and like they were coming after Kirby hard because it was two things. One, a bunch of people started doing not copycat, but like they started doing other Bridge series. Check the channel. And two, Four Kids or whoever made Yu-Gi-Oh! Started like, hey, what are you doing? No, copyright. So like they're railing against the machine. You know, little Kirby fighting for all the other Bridge series. He literally laid the groundwork.
Honestly.
They were like, you can't use it. He's like, listen, I'm taking your crappy 30-minute episode. Sorry. Yu-Gi-Oh's not crappy.
Oh, yeah.
We're taking your 30-minute episodes. I'm going to put it in 7 minutes, and I'm changing everything about it. I'm sorry. I think that's fair use. And as you can see, apparently he won his fight.
But he technically didn't buy it from them, and it was their property.
It is licensed, but it is so altered to this point. It looks not... I don't want to say it looks nothing like the original, but it's been altered enough that it's impossible for you to confuse this with the original series.
True. That is a fact.
Fair use.
Fair use.
Hey, if you made this friend, you haven't already, drop a sub on the channel, drop a like. We're gonna get started on episode 38 reaction. Yeah.
What the D stands for in Yu-Gi-Oh! 5Ds. Don't watch it.
Man, this tournament is longer than any given Metal Gear Solid cutscene, and only slightly less interactive. But at least we're on our way to the finals.
They sure hope we don't encounter any
more. Same for dams, five dams.
Oh, yeah?
Somebody say intrusive subplot?
Oh, son of a bitch.
Intrusive subplot.
So, like, where's Yugi? I feel like we haven't seen him for a while.
Hello, I'm Jean-Claude Magnum. You may remember me from such films as Teenage Space Ninjas from Outer Space, Devil Ninja vs. Santa Claus, and Devil Ninja 2, Electric Boogaloo.
Okay, I know that. Okay. Are these real movies? The last one? No.
Fanboy. Hey, do you mind if I start incessantly quoting all your movies? Because I really, really, really like doing that.
Oof. My Valentine. I'd recognize that cleavage anywhere.
Wow. I can't believe you're being seduced by my favorite thinly veiled parody of a Belgian kickboxer. You should ask him to autograph your boobs. Oh, better idea. Ask him to autograph my boobs.
I've been stalking
my boobs.
You beat me in a
such a fangirl.
I haven't been able to get you out of my head.
Sorry, pal, but I already have a love interest. Who's that, Mai? Is it Tristan? It's Tristan, isn't it? For the love of God, tell me it ain't Tristan.
It's you, Joey.
But you're 10 years older than me.
What?
I know. Creepy, isn't it?
Actually, this is the closest thing the show has to a normal relationship.
You may be a
on God.
Guy, but I still want you to be my wife.
Oh
what
my.
Say, sugar tits?
I know how she feels. Guys are proposing to me all the time.
Duke, I already told you I was joking.
Sorry, Jean-Claude, but I would never marry somebody so selfish and superficial.
But my, isn't that exactly what you were like in season one? Face it, the only difference between the two of you is about 20 pounds of silicone. My breasts are not...
Oh my God.
Right.
I don't believe you.
If you won't marry me,
get fucked up. Right, everybody.
Wow. You lose, you have to become my wife.
I accept.
Oh, that's not creepy at all.
Reason. Hey, I have a rather pertinent question.
There
what
is.
Does any of this have to do with anything? Seriously, aren't we trying to save the world from imminent destruction by vaguely evil forces? When did the love life of my Valentine become so freaking important? Is the next plot point going to revolve around Bakura's stamp collection?
Damn.
It just pisses me off is all. I summoned my Amazon warrior.
Wow. He had so much to say.
What the hell is this?
Celebrity ninjas. Why is everybody in this guy's deck a fucking ninja?
Come on, Mai. I know you can beat this ass clown.
But Joey, I thought you were Jean-Claude Magnum's biggest fan. Why the sudden change of heart?
I've tried to deny it, Yug, but I can't hold it back anymore. I think I felt this way from the moment I first laid eyes on her.
You mean?
Yes. I am in love with my Valentine. Breasts. Even if they're as real as a $3 bill. My breasts.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Right.
Wow, they're coming for her neck.
You'll be married, Mai, but you won't. won't just be marrying me. You'll be marrying the Church of Scientology.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
I'm a member of the Hollywood cult, just like every other deluded celebrity you used to like, such as Isaac Hayes, Jason Lee, and Rufus the Naked Mole Rat.
Oh, that's...
No, no! Not Rufus! Not Rufus!
They got Rufus?
What, 5 now? When I grow up, I want to be just like my...
Always the best of them. Surgery.
What the hell makes you think I'm going to pay for breast implants? My breasts are not...
Right!
She... every time! Right!
I punch him in the face.
And also for you to pledge millions of
every
dollars
time,
to
one
the Church
of
them. Scientology so that we can finally defeat the evil galactic overlord Xenu and protect the hapless Thetans all over the world from being thrown into volcanoes.
So let me get this straight. The only characters on this show who represent America are Jean-Claude Magnum, Rebecca Hawkins, Maximilian Pegasus, and Bandit Keith. Is it just me, or is Yu-Gi-Oh! The most xenophobic show ever?
I play Cyber Harpies, destroying
well,
remaining life points.
It's pretty accurate representation of the shit we produce, so like...
I can't believe we found a duelist even worse than mine!
I can't believe we actually acknowledge this worthless episode.
I can't believe it's not butter.
If you won't marry me, then I'm going to kidnap you instead. Since that
what?
What the hell?
Response to anything on this show.
What? Wait, is that a rocket kite?
Thought. Come to me, my...
I'm confused.
A fucking rocket kite.
I'm confused.
Swear to God.
On her couch like a giant infant.
Jeez, lady, those fake boobs are heavy.
Is that Jiraiya?
They're not fake. She's going to fall to her untimely death.
Yeah.
What would L. Ron Hubbard do?
I see London, I see France, I see my Valentine's underpants. Joey, stop gawking at my nethers and save my butt.
Nethers.
Can I do both? Just shut up and catch
right?
me.
Right? Why can't you do both?
Whatever you do, don't let go.
Terrible stance. Oh my God.
I killed a man with my breasts. So, my, I don't suppose you're still sore about that whole attempted kidnapping thing, are you?
Sorry, Jean-Claude asshole, but I'd rather have fake breasts than a fake religion.
Looks like you win this round.
She admitted it.
Thanks for
no, she said she would
life.
Rather.
I guess.
Be having the concussions now.
Now we can finally walk down this road and go to the Battle City Finals, which is exactly what we were doing before we were sidetracked by this redundant shit fest of an episode.
Yugi has so much to say. Say with your chest,
yo. I feel like that's the most lines Yugi himself has had. Not Yami, Yugi.
You're right.
So what do you plan to do once you reclaim your body?
Well, that should be obvious. The first thing I'm gonna do is get laid. And then I'm gonna get laid again. Then do some crack and get laid some more. That's what I'm all about. Getting f***ed.
Jean-Claude Magnum. What a douchebag. I haven't been this disappointed by a talented actor since Christian Bale in Howl's Moving Castle.
I want you off the
damn
set, you prick. Are you professional or not? Do I f***ing walk around?
That was
Am
him.
I gonna walk around and rip your f***ing lights down in the middle of a scene? Then why the f*** are you walking right through? Like this in the background. What the f*** is it with you?
That was episode 38, and... I'm glad Yugi said what I was thinking. Why the fuck are we having a My Valentine episode?
Yo, I don't know. Well, I think it was more to see, like, the Joey My Valentine connection. Like, even though it was just the end. I think that was the moment that they were trying to do. Still a waste.
But we're still going to ignore that. She's clearly, like, way older than him.
Yes.
Is he not in high school or just barely?
Does she not own...
That's hot girl shit. That's like
hot
cougar
girl
stuff.
Shit. What?
Can't
Maybe.
Talk right now. She's doing hot girl shit, including winning children's card games. Question.
Yes.
Technically, was there an end to that game? Did somebody actually win?
No.
Okay, good to know. So let me get this straight, right? Let me paint a picture for you all. In the middle of the duel, Jiraiya on a fucking rocket kite comes through, snatches her up.
Yep.
She wiggles a little bit. He drops her, and she grabs onto something midair. Why is there a goddamn rocket kite?
I don't know.
But at the beginning, we got to see it was Bakura's show for a whole episode, and just like we all thought, it would suck.
Boring as shit.
It wasn't boring as shit, but a lot of it didn't make sense. The zombie kid is wearing a zombie mask, takes off the zombie mask, and it's just more fucking zombie. Right? Am I crazy, or it was just more zombie? It's like Chuck Norris, there's no beard, there's no chin under this beard, it's just more fist. It's just more zombie, I guess. Jeez. We're moving on to Battle City Finals, aka Duel Kingdom 2.0, aka the end of the road for the Yugi-Oh gang, and we're gonna see how they're gonna finish this off. So with that being said, if you made this far and you haven't already, drop a sub on the channel, drop a like on the video, comment down below what was your favorite part of the Bakura slash my special, and we barely got any Yugi. If you wanna catch me live, I'm live on Twitch every Monday and Friday, 7 p.m. Eastern. Don't forget to hit the bell for post notifications, because we do post content multiple times a week on the channel. You don't want to miss out. Also,
don't forget to check the top pinned comment and the description below for all the socials, including the Reddit, the Discord, and the Patreon,
where you can find uncut, unreleased anime reactions. I'm your man behind the cam.
I'm Miss Kent.
Stay nasty, y'all.
You're nasty.